We're just finishing our setup. My name is Dominique, everyone calls me Dom, and I'm here with Jocelyn and Christina. We're gonna be working in the hot shop today to do a hot gloss demo. And we're gonna be making a snow globe. And Jocelyn tends to make a lot of mushrooms, so we're gonna put a mushroom in the snow globe. And Christina makes a whole line of snails, so we're gonna put the snail in the snow globe too. During this time, we are open, willing, ready. We want to answer any questions that you have. So type them on in the comments. If you are watching this later, then feel free to type them in the comments as well, and I'll make sure to check back frequently. Everything in here is done on the end of a long rod. So I have a rod right here that I'm heating up just a little bit more. And to get started on this, I'm going to be making our base. So I'm going to gather a little bit of glass out of my furnace. First, I wanted to make sure this was hot, otherwise the glass wouldn't stick to it. My furnace runs around 2,200 degrees. Inside is 145 pounds of melted clear glass when it's full. So I have a little bit of clear glass. It looks orange, but I promise it's just clear. It's just super hot. I'm going to go in some color. Over on this table, a little out of your view, we have some crushed up chunks of colored glass that we call Frit. F-R-I-T, Frit. And the color that I went in is called Dense Green. It is an opaque, light green. And this is going to represent our grass today. We're going kind of simple with the base. I'm just swirling the color up a little bit, and it's just going to be some green. Now the base is going to be a little bigger than the amount of material I have right here. So I'm going to let this get a little more cold and stable before I go back in the furnace and wrap clear glass around it. Oftentimes that's how we do things. We have a layer, maybe add some color or design to that layer, go back in the furnace, and completely cover that design or color with a layer of clear glass. To make larger things, you simply keep going in the furnace over and over again, getting more and more layers until you have your desired mass. Relatively cold right now. You can kind of hear the sound. So I'm going to go back in the furnace and wrap more glass around it. When you're gathering glass from the furnace, the best way to describe it is that you are getting a little bit of honey on the end of a toothpick. But you can't dribble that honey anywhere, because it's molten material, right? I want to organize this glass a little more. So I'm using this tool called a wood block to shape it. These are made out of fruit wood, and they're very waterlogged. They hang out in water all the time. So when they hit the heat of the glass, they create a layer of steam, and therefore the glass is rolling and shaping on the steam. Now we're gonna start flattening our base. I pre-made the whole top part of the snow globe, and it is about 4 inches tall from the inside and 3.5 to 3.75 at the opening. So I want my base to be around that size too. That way we'll have a nice seal. When I say I pre-made it, I mean, I basically made two globe tops that I would compare to thicker then Akilin that's right behind the camera. That kiln's holding at 960 degrees. Right before we're about to pick it up, I need to remember to ramp it up to around 1,000, maybe 1,025. That way we can pick it up and encapsulate our inside design. Paddle on. Jocelyn has a paddle. And I have another tool, paddle off. We're creating the shape of the base, working as a team. And then I'm gonna check our sides. And we're actually there. To make this a little easier, once the glass is cold, we're gonna do a random little flip right now. It's called a punty, P-U-N-T-Y. This will allow us to break off of this rod and meet in the other side that I'm touching right here. Punties are used for a lot of things in glass. Typically they're used when you're making a vessel, such as a cup or a vase. The top or the lip of the cup or vase is on the blowpipe. In order to open that up, you need to flip it over onto a temporary handle. So I'm gonna wait until I'm not wiggling around at all, and then Jocelyn's gonna get me that punty. So a punty is a solid rod with a little bit of glass on it, and that little bit of glass supports the entire weight of the piece for the rest of the time that we work on it. It's quite amazing. Are you gonna stay on it? Yeah, that would be good. As you're gonna see in here for all these projects that we do, glass blowing is a team thing. It's all about communicating and working with each other. You come up with a design in here, you're not gonna be able to do it by yourself. Especially the more complicated designs, the better the glass blower, the bigger and fancier the designs, and typically the larger the team. With COVID, we just started working together a little bit more. But you can see we're masks on and trying to be thoughtful. We aren't inviting the public into this studio at the time because it's so up close and personal that it's hard not to be in each other's space. Jocelyn has my punty. I'm gonna toss it on the bottom in the middle the best I can. And then I'm gonna put a bunch of water up at the top of my pipe so that it'll break free of my pipe and the whole bottom will be on Jocelyn's. I got water on the top just so you know. So now Jocelyn can heat and decorate and kind of shape that part. The part that's going into the hole right now is the part that we're gonna be putting our little mushrooms on. So Jocelyn makes the cutest little dancing mushrooms on the torch, and they're made to stick in a plant. And in here, she's been working on making larger mushrooms. So I thought this would be a fun way to collaborate. Christina, you want to get her color ready for whatever mushroom she wants? And for this idea, we have to give some credit to one of the artists that inspired us. Her name is Liz Idaho Art. I'll make sure to put it in the comments. But I was looking for an awesome present for Joss for Christmas, and I found a woman that makes ceramic mushrooms. So I got Joss a ceramic mushroom, and I've been following this lady for a while. And she made the cutest line of mushrooms that were holding snails. So I immediately knew that was a project that I wanted to do with Jocelyn in glass. And Christina has recreated in our form. Now when you're an artist, obviously, you always want to be kind of original with your design. You don't want to be copying people. So even though we're taking her design and making it our own, I just wanted to make it clear that she inspired this design. That's the polite way to go about it. I'll make sure to put her page in our comments too. Now, Christina's got a little rod. She's got a little bit of white glass on it, and we're getting ready to make the mushrooms. So this will be what sits on the table. This is going to be inside the snow globe. Are you done with the white, or are you going in it again? I'm just going to show them. So Christina's going in some white grit, and it's just basically crushed up chunks of colored glass. That's compatible with the glass that I melt in my furnace. For any glass blowers, I'm melting this kind of glass called Boma. It's really quite nice. I buy it by the ton. And it comes in 55-pound bags, kind of like you would buy pellets for your pellet stove. Oh, hey, Becky. So if you have any questions, feel free to type in the comments. I do have a little computer going on the side. If you're on Instagram, thanks for tuning in. This is our first time going live on Instagram while we're doing this. You can feel free to give us some comments on Instagram. Let us know what you'd like to see us doing different. For Facebook, we've got you up on a computer as well, so we can see what's going on. Do you want to just push that bottom straight whenever you feel like it? So Christina and Jocelyn are going through making mushrooms. Under you. Christina's got glass. She's getting it really hot. And then they're kind of piecing it together. Is that going to be a cookie or is that another mushroom?
Yeah, we
grabbed
that
on the table
and
Alexa has a gas. Yeah. Do you want me to get you another mushroom ready?
Yeah.
So I'm going to, I think Jocelyn wants to do 3 mushrooms. So I'm going to get her next mushroom lady ready while Christina and Jocelyn work on the cap of the first one. Everything in here is typically always done starting pulling glass out of the furnace. Because my furnace, I only have one of them, it's filled with just clear. Sometimes studios have 2, or maybe they do a production run of a whole bunch of one color. And then maybe they'd have a color pop. But I just have clear, so I gathered, I went in the white, and now I'm using a little table to shape it a smidge. Before I bring it over to Jocelyn, nice and hot.
Do you want another mushroom? I think 2 is good.
Sure. a little bubble on it, but I think it's cute. In order to make the tops of the mushrooms, what we're doing is we're using this pair of shears called diamond shears, and we're just cutting it and leaving it on the table like a little hot patty. Now this kind of glass in particular, we call it soft glass. It's very prone to shattering and exploding. You're gonna notice we sit at the bench, we kind of adjust it however we see fit, and then we go into the reheating furnace to make sure it stays nice and warm. We're deciding where the snail's gonna go. Okay. We're ready. So Christina does snails in different ways depending on the size. And for this one, she decided that she's going to flame work it. So we have a really hot torch in here. It runs on propane and oxygen. And she's gonna use pre-pulled rods of glass that are colorful. And it's the same kind of glass that's in my furnace. And you see she's heating it up like a pencil. And she's gonna use that to draw the snail on. In here, we do two different types of work. We do hot shop work, like you see. Old Venetian styles, typical functional stuff. Or we work in the flame shop, which is on a torch. In the flame shop, you can make things much more intricate. You have a lot more control about your detail and your design. So it's kind of fun to take those skills from the flame shop and apply them into the hot shop. And it allows us to add some more decoration to our piece. Once more, she has a pencil of glass. She's heating it up inside the torch. As it gets hot, the glass kind of boils up and she can collect more material. We call that gathering. And she's getting the right amount of material to make her little snail body. Doing a cute little mini snail on top of our mushroom. Now Christina has a whole bunch of snails up on her website if you are a snail lover. She does little baby ones, and then we did a whole bunch of big fancy ones here in the pawn shop too, so you could basically get a snail that's the size of a paperweight. Tuning in right now. We really appreciate you spending your time with us. The reheating furnace that Jocelyn keeps going in, I actually run mine pretty hot. So it's around 2,400 degrees. I turn that on and off every workday. Turn the torch to the side of you. That runs on propane and forced air. So it's not quite as hot as the torch that's in Christina's hand, actually, because the torch runs on oxygen. You see that bright blue flame? That's a really, really hot flame. Jocelyn went into the reheating furnace, make sure everything was feeling nice and toasty. And then Christina can use a little metal tool as an extension of her hands to kind of shape the cute little snail. Glass is always heating and cooling, so it gets nice and warm in there. Then as it stays out, it gets cooler and cooler. If it gets too cold, or if it takes any drastic changes in temperature, it will pop and shatter and even explode.
Pretty cute.
All right. my vase, and Josh, you want to get my cup? And Josh, you want to put a glove on, I'll put a glove down just in case you pull away from it again.
Other way for a minute. And flip.
creamer, and if I get the pick pot, I can drill a hole into the glass. Last time I learned, if I didn't make the hole big enough, it was a pain in the butt. So I got a little bit of a bigger hole. I think we got a horseman toxin. We're looking pretty good though.
Otherwise, I'll see you next Wednesday at 3 o'clock. I'll have a different demo planned. Bye.